أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته This is Ms. Sadia Rizwan and today we are going to learn about solar eclipse Students you can see the images What are these showing Yes, they are showing solar eclipses when the moon comes in front of the sun. But what is actually eclipse and what is meant by solar eclipse? Let us discuss. What is an eclipse? An eclipse occurs when one object in space blocks an observer from seeing another object in space. From Earth, there are two main types of eclipses, solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse when sun comes in between and solar eclipse when moon comes in between. Now solar eclipse. A solar eclipse occurs when the moon passes in front of the sun, causing a shadow to fall on certain portions of the earth. The eclipse is not seen from every place on earth, but only from the locations where the shadow falls. From these locations, it appears as if the sun has gone dark. Now students, you can see this is sun, this is earth, And the moon is in between the sun and the earth, blocking away the sun rays towards the earth. That is why earth is having dark side at that time. We are feeling dark at that time. Now, students, what are the causes of a solar eclipse? A solar eclipse is a natural phenomena. When the moon passes between the sun and the earth, it causes a solar eclipse actually. Obviously, beta. Causing the sun to become fully partial covered. Eclipses are regular occurrence made possible by the elliptical, means oval shape, orbit of the moon around the earth and earth's elliptical orbit around the sun. Now, what are the effects of a solar eclipse? Annular, partial or a hybrid eclipse is still unsafe to view because even though parts of the sun are covered in the moon's umbra, The parts which aren't covered are still unsafe to view. A solar eclipse is easier to view than the sun because it's less bright. Even so, looking at partial or annular eclipse can permanently damage the eyes. So be careful, students. The position of the sun and the moon causes the tides to become stronger because the gravitational pull of the sun and the moon are stronger when they are aligned. The shadow of the moon can make the earth a few degrees colder and the winds may possibly be stronger according to certain experiments. Now, what are the causes? Solar eclipse, radiation from sun, high magnetic fields causing explosions. Now, the effects of the solar eclipse, satellite disruption, power grid disruption or reduction, you can say, electricity down, there will be a complete blackout and radio wave. Disruption. Now the question arises, what effect does solar eclipse have on humans? Now we are human beings. What effect does solar eclipse on us? Let us discuss. Total solar eclipse produce harmful rays that can cause blindness. During a total solar eclipse, when the disk of the moon fully covers the sun, the brilliant corona emits only electromagnetic radiations. Though sometimes it's a greenish hue. Now, why are solar eclipse dangerous or why your elders say to their kids that solar eclipse are dangerous? Let us discuss. Looking directly at the photosphere of the sun, the bright disk of the sun itself, even for just a few seconds, can cause permanent damage to the retina of the eye. Because of the intense visible and invisible radiation that photosphere emits. Now students, you can see a picture of the mountainous area. Right now it's a daytime. As you can see sun, you can see the ring of the sun. But over here the moon is blocking away the sun rays. That is why we are feeling like a night over here. But actually it's a day. Why it's a night? Why we are feeling it's like night? Because the sun is blocking the sun rays. Sorry, the moon is blocking the sun rays. which is coming towards the earth. Now, these children are looking directly at the sun, and this adult as well. But what will happen? What do you think? What will happen to them? Yes, students, it will damage their eyes, or you can say it can permanently have the blindness. So if you want to see, if you are very curious about it, so there are a few ways you can see it, but it is advisable to stay home. Now, how to look at the sun and not go blind? Do not look directly at the sun. Unfiltered sunlight will damage your eyes and could cause permanent blindness. Sunglasses will not provide sufficient protection. Only look at the sun through an approved solar filter. Even safer to observe indirectly by projecting the sun's image with a pinhole binoculars. Safe solar viewing, eclipse glasses or welder's goggles, specially designed solar telescopes or solar binoculars, telescope cameras with approved solar filters, and pinhole projector. Again, I'm advising you, students, do not use normal sunglasses. Why? Because it will damage your eyes, or it may permanently cause blindness. So it is advisable to stay home and stay safe. Now, solar eclipse, eye safety. What is not safe? Ordinary sunglasses are not strong enough to protect the eyes. There are different types of sunglasses, maybe expensive or cheap. It doesn't mean if they are so expensive so that they can save us from the solar eclipse. No, none of the type of these sunglasses are safer to view solar eclipse. What is safe? Use specially designed solar eclipse glasses and viewers to block the sun's harmful rays. Now, this is specially designed solar eclipse glasses, and this is an eclipse viewer. You can see it through it. It won't damage your eyes because these are the specially designed for it. Now, what is not safe? Wearing solar eclipse glasses to look through a camera, binoculars or telescope will not protect your eyes. But what is safe? Use only specially designed filters for lenses. Means you have to use perfect lenses for specially designed filtered lenses to look at this. For this, you have to wear these type of glasses or the viewer. Now, if you want to go out, if you are so curious, so there are a few things. How do I view the solar eclipse? But I must say, again, I'm advising you, it is safer to stay inside the home. Now, if you want to see, there are a few ways. Step number one, go outside your house. Step number two, put on your eclipse glasses. Never look directly at the sun without them. Means if you are not wearing it properly, it will damage your eyes. It means you have to wear it very properly. You have to take care of every precautions. Step number three, look up and say, wow, oh, and ah. Repeat it with me. Wow, oh, and ah. Students, I'm advising you again, do not use sunglasses to look the solar eclipse. What will happen then? It will damage your eyes or may cause permanent blindness. Last but not the least, let us discuss about Namaz-e-Kasuf. Namaz-e-Kasuf is a special prayer offered for solar eclipse. Namaz-e-Kasuf, wo namaz hai jo suraj girhan ke waqt padhi jati hai. Now, what actually Namaz-e-Kasuf is? Salatul Kusuf, in Arabic we can say Salatul Kusuf is a prayer consisting of two rakah performed during a solar eclipse. Means during a solar eclipse, we have to offer two rakah for the solar eclipse. While Salatul Khushuf is a two rakah prayer performed during a lunar eclipse. They are performed by the Muslim community in congregations. Now it means tomorrow when we'll be citing solar eclipse in Pakistan, it is advisable to stay home from 8 a.m. till 2 p.m. so that you will be safer. Do not go outside. Do not look outside the window. Take care of everything. offer namaz-e-kasuf, recite astaghfar, give sadqa and khairat. May Allah Ta'ala help us all. I hope, students, you have enjoyed this short description of solar eclipse, and I'm sure you all will take precautionary measures. You won't go outside and look directly at the sun. Take care, students. Allah Hafiz. We'll meet you next time. Take care. Allah Hafiz.